Amigos, welcome one, welcome all. It is time for the show with no name exclusively on Vaughn Radio. And I hope you guys are ready to rock today because it's not just any ordinary day. No way, guys. Today is Friday, and I'm sure you guys are all as excited as I am for the weekend. And if you're not, well, by the end of this show, you're going to be in a great mood. Vais a estar de buen humor. I can guarantee it. And you're going to learn some English and have some fun along the way. So guys, if you're listening right now on Vaughn Radio or you're listening via podcast, I just want to let you know that you can tune into this show every single day. Well, every single weekday, I should say, on Grupo Vaughn's Instagram. So if you go over to Grupo underscore Vaughn and go over to their stories, or if you can't watch it live, you can see this program on their Instagram TV. So you don't only have to listen to this radio program, you can actually watch it. So good morning to all our amigos who are joining us here on Instagram, on Vaughn's Instagram. Remember, if you want to follow Vaughn, aside from this radio show and many other things, they're constantly sharing contenido, to help you improve your English. So you should be following Vaughn. It's Grupo underscore Vaughn on Instagram. Make sure you're following, or I should say subscribing, on YouTube, because Vaughn has a plethora of content over there. Ah, te gusta esa palabra, eh? A plethora of content. They've got tons of content to help you learn English. And if that's not enough, you also have Richard Vaughn on TV, La Dos, Channel 2, every single morning from 7:30 to 8 a.m. From 7:30 to 8 a.m., you've got a master class with the master himself, Richard Vaughn, and he will guide you through the basics of this language. And as I told you guys, if you're not taking advantage of this, I don't know why. Is it because you don't want to get up early? Because it's like a free half-hour English class with the master every morning, and the key word there is free. Of course, if you want to follow along, he's going right from one of our, I would say our Bibles, nuestras Biblias, which is the student manual. And he's going through it page by page, one page, and he's even telling you, I'm on page 25. We're looking at this, and this way you can follow along, and as always, aloud. In voz alta, coming up with your own examples, all right? But if you do that every day, and you listen to the show with no name, which is a two-hour show, you listen to Fitz, which is another two-hour show, no excuses, and you listen to Richard in the morning, and you're not improving your English, I don't know what you're doing wrong, you know? And I know most of you are definitely improving and definitely feeling more confident with each week that passes, right? So Art Savudia says, I love his voice. Richard Vaughn is superb. Yeah, well, he's a master communicator, and he also knows his stuff. Sabe de lo que habla. He knows about history, politics, business. He's a well-rounded guy, como diríamos en Estados Unidos. A well-rounded, sabe un poquitín de todo, ¿no? So catch him every morning, 7:30 to 8 a.m., and then afterwards on the radio. And remember, if you're really serious and you want to, you know, make the most of your free time this summer, then I would definitely get our online course. It's $99, which is a steal, un chollo, $99 for the year. And that's video, that's audio, and also there are tests and all kinds of things. And if you want to take it even a step further, you can sign up for our video conference classes, which are available too. So if you want more information, contact us via any of our social media channels, or contact us via phone, however, whatever's easier for you. And as I said, get your free level test. Even if you're not sure what you want to do, ask them, can I get a level test? I want to get some kind of evaluation and see where I'm at and where I need to go. And I think that's something everybody could use, you know, even myself. I would love to have a level test. Any Spanish teachers out there who want to level test me? Just checking. All right, well, guys, as always, this show is totally interactive. You can participate with us on Instagram, on Twitter, wherever you feel comfortable participating. In fact, there are so many people who are here but are not here. And I want to send a shout out to those silent students who write to me in private and say, listen, I'm a shy guy or I'm a shy gal, or I listen to the podcast, but I still do the work. We love you guys too, even those of you who aren't participating in real time. The key is to participate, and you got the idea. So hello to all of you who tune in via podcast on iVox and iTunes. We love you just as much as those of you who are able to be here with us in real time. You're all important to us. You're all special. And speaking of podcasts, new episode of my podcast, which is FYI, self-produced, autoproducido. FYI, it's called For Your Inglés. It's a weekly podcast. It comes out every Friday morning. And this week we're looking at grilling and chilling. Now, grilling is haciendo barbacoa, and chilling is de tranquis, right? And those are things that everybody likes, right? And what I thought it was apropos is appropriate, a French way to say it, but we say it in English, because tomorrow is a big celebration. It's a day that's synonymous with barbecuing and pool parties, and I'm talking about the 4th of July. The 4th of July is this weekend, tomorrow, in the United States. So guys, if you want to celebrate and see how we celebrate and learn some vocabulary, make sure you subscribe to my podcast, FYI. It just came out. It's hot off the press, this episode, BBQ, barbecue, and it came out like 2 hours ago. So enjoy it and let me know what you think. And I always say this, the same thing I tell you with Vaughn. If you like our podcasts, if you like our shows, rate them, valóralos. I was going to say value them, pero digo, espera, eso, value es otra cosa, como quiero. I know you value them, but if you guys could rate them too, that's great, because it gives the show with no name, no excuses, FYI, whichever one, it gives it more visibility. And that just means that your classroom, your online classroom, just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. And that's cool, because the more, the merrier. Cuanto más, mejor, the more the merrier. So I see so many people on board. Looks like you guys might be ready to lift off, right? ¿Queréis despegar? I think it's time for lift off.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Ignition. Lift off. Lift off.
Strap on your seatbelt. Fasten your seatbelts. Hold on to your hats. And get ready for the ride of your life. The show with no name. It's show with no name time.
Right, guys, we are officially airborne, and welcome. Who knows where we're going to end up, donde acabaremos hoy, but I promise you, we're going to have some exciting, interactive adventures along the way. Speaking of interactive, I've got a couple comments, well, lots of comments, but I'm going to sort through them and just read a couple of them, and then we'll get started with our Say What soundbite. Mari Nuri says, I enjoy listening to the whole Vaughn team. Always I can. Cuidado, it's whenever. Ese siempre que pueda is whenever I can. Okay? So thank you. Thank you, Mari Nuri. And I always say too, when I say thank you, I'm not just speaking for myself. I speak on behalf of, en nombre of all my team. of not just the radio team, I can speak on behalf of our teachers and our sales team and our marketing team. Why? Because I know, I live Vaughn. You guys know this. For me, Vaughn is not a company, it's a family. And I mean that, you guys know that. You know, you've seen, I think you can see my admiration for Richard Vaughn. It's evident. I think you can see all of our admiration for Richard Vaughn. You know, he's the captain of the ship and he chose his team. And I'm so proud to be a part of that team. And, you know, that's how we discovered each other, through this amazing tool called Vaughn Radio. So it's a pleasure, as I say, I know I say it every day, but I can't say it enough. It's a pleasure to have you guys here with us every day and have such eager, you know, willing students who are just up for anything. Estáis para todo. And that is great. Vicky says, I take my hat off to you, Alberto. Oh, all right. Thank you. She says, FYI, every week I think is awesome. But then another Friday comes and you better yourself. En vez de get better yourself, creo que quieres decir you better, te mejoras, ¿no? Pero get better es como mejorate tú, ¿no? Get better, I hope you get better. Pero to better yourself es mejorarte, okay? Es reflexivo. If that could be. And she says, by the way, I'm in for that barbecue. All right, well, Vicky's coming to our barbecue too. Is there anybody who's not coming to our barbecue? You're not going to want to miss it. As I said, you can download the new episode on iTunes, iVox. If you need help finding it, just write me a message on social media and I can help you, because I'm on Stitcher. I don't even know all the different podcasts I'm on. So DL Mateo says, new episode, barbecue. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We learn a lot of interesting things in the episode. I always tell you this, the same thing with the show with no name. If I'm learning things, preparing these scripts, well, then maybe you're learning things too. And I don't just mean in English, right? Because I know the English part, but then I have to learn, you know, different things about the history of barbecuing and where the word came from. So I love that part. That's another part of my job that I love. And that's researching. Of course, as Mari Nuri says, or Vicky said, excuse me, it takes up a lot of time. But when you love what you do, it makes it a little bit easier. And when I get feedback from you guys telling me how much you love the pod, how much you love the show with no name, well, check out now. Here's the bad thing, guys. If you're listening right now, you can't see the huge smile on my face. If you're watching us on Vaughn's Instagram, then you can see that I am beaming, right? To beam is to let out a huge smile. Mari Nuri says, another riveting episode. Ah, buena. And that was a word that we learned in the jeans episode, cuando hice el capítulo de vaqueros, because rivets are those metal things on the jeans that keep them together, right? But riveting is something that is, wow, it's fascinating. It's riveting. So Mari Nuri, your vocabulary has already improved tremendously. Great stuff. And she says, they're all amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. Rosa says, the more, the merrier. No, Rosa, sin el R. Entonces, la expresión es, the more, the merrier. No, es como se diría, the more, the better. The more, the fast, you know. So, the more, the merrier. Como Merry Christmas, pero la Y se convierte en I, y ponemos ER. The more, the merrier. Okay, so just be careful there. There it is. Rosa got it. You self-corrected there. La Churri says, thank you, all of your team. It's a present for us. Well, you know what? I feel, La Churri, you guys feel lucky that you found us. And we feel lucky that you found us too. So it's a mutual thing. And I think when that happens, it's beautiful. Giggler says, I'll be there in spirit at the barbecue. Sure, we'll save you a burger or something. Why not? J.M. Hermosilla, I see you guys, everybody's mouth is watering, huh? J.M. Hermosilla says, I love the crackling and sizzling of the barbecue. Oh, man, qué palabrones. You guys are learning a lot, it seems, from the show with no name and from FYI, from No Excuses as well, Richard Vaughn. Let's take a look. Jennifer says, hi, Alberto. Today is 9 months ago since my couple kissed me. Not my couple, my partner. This is a very common mistake. So your partner, there are two partners and those two partners are a couple. Couple is la pareja y mi pareja is my partner. Okay, so careful, it's confusing. So you would say, my partner kissed me for the first time. Could you dedicate some words to David and me, please? Of course I can, Jennifer and David, on your 9-month anniversary of your first kiss. May it last forever. All right, well here's a song for you. I'm gonna sing you a love song for you. Dedicated to Jennifer and her lovely boyfriend, David, okay? Wise men say, only fools rush in, for I can help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, some things were meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you. Let love rule. Que reina el amor. For I can. Well, guys, hey, I got all choked up. Me emociono. Yo no soy el que recibí el beso. I didn't even get the kiss and I'm all choked up. Isn't love a beautiful thing? Love is my father says it. Love is the essence of life. La esencia de la vida, right? When you smell it, that beautiful smell, the flowers, the beach, whatever it is, the trees, there it is. All right, so my amigos, let love rule. Ahí te dedico otra también de Lenny Kravitz. You got to let love rule. Let love rule. You got to let love rule. There you go. Oh, y Alex, cómo no. Love is in the air. Fill in the blanks. What you? Ah, hasta ahí llegado. Love is in the air. ¿Y cómo va esa frase? Okay, there's your first pop quiz. Vuestro primer trivia del día. So, anybody know what goes after that? Don't Google it. Aquí no vale Google. So I'll start it. You fill in the blanks. Love is in the air. What you? Everywhere I look around, muy bien, Anix. Pero tú sabes, I would say 99% of the people in Spain think that the next lyric is what you want, right? Bueno, de todas las canciones en general es what you, right? I've got chills to what you watching, and I'm losing control. All right, well, guys, I am in a sing-songy mood, if you can't tell. I think there's something, aside from love in the air, it's Friday, and you can feel it, you can tell. I can feel it in my fingers, I can feel it in my bones. But you know what, guys? That doesn't mean we're going to get out of these challenges we have to do. We have a lot of challenges to do today, so let's kick off with a little challenge that we call Say What?
Say what?
That's right, my amigos, it's the Say What soundbite only on the show with no name. And as always, well, this is your first big challenge, right? I gave you a little pop quiz, but that doesn't count. This is your first big challenge. So guys, you're going to hear someone speaking right now, and I want to know who it is. I want to know what that person is saying. And remember, you're going to have four chances to get this down. All right, amigos? So everybody pay close attention. Grab a pen, grab a piece of paper, and write down what you hear.
I am here today because I cannot be there with you today. But thank you for coming. Thank you for your resolve, your generosity of spirit. I thank President Correa for the courage he has shown in considering and in granting me political asylum.
There we go, folks. So, I think the guy speaks crystal clear, right? I mean, he's not mumbling. He's not like, well, you know, I just want to say that, you know. I think he's really enunciating his words and you might not know the vocabulary, but it's clear as day, right? So observations, guys. Does anybody recognize the voice? Does anybody recognize the accent? What's going on, right? Rosa says, yes, he's Soek. I think you got a typo there. I think he is Britain. Él es Britannia. Or he's British. No, mejor, Mari. You think he's British. Okay. So, hey, not bad. Well, we accept all observations. Rosa says he speaks clearly. Absolutely. I think we can all agree on that. Whether you understand it all or not is one thing, but you can't ask the guy to speak any clearer, right? So maybe he's a politician? I don't know. I'm asking you. J.M. Hermosilla says it's a speech in a celebration, okay, or at a celebration. I like that. Yeah, because it seems like he's celebrating, right? Liz says it's definitely a speech, but you're asking me, but you're saying it. You just confused me, Liz. It's definitely a speech? Wait a second. D.L. Mateo says it's a speech. La Churri says, I think it's a politic man. Sería politician, La Churri, okay? Politician. Eso es para mujer o hombre, okay? Politician. Leonardo says, he doesn't have the power of ubiquity. Ooh, I love your crypticness. Is that Dan Brown? Leonardo? The Da Vinci Code? I love you, Leonardo. Tú sabes que te quiero. So MJ says a politician. Okay, so I've heard that a couple times now. We've heard a politician. I heard, what about the accent? I heard some people say British. What are you guys getting as far as or in the way of accent? Anybody catch a specific thing that they said, oh, I recognize that accent. Ludi says, I think I know him. Or I think I know who it is. He's talking to former President Correa. Ah, okay. Not bad. I heard something about that in there too. That's a good key, context, in context there. Annex says, it's a speech. I can't tell where his accent comes from, or I can't place his accent, but he speaks crystal clear. Okay. J.M. Hermosilla says, sounds like an open English pronunciation. Perhaps he's German or Autrichian, Austrian, querías decir? Austriaco? Austrian or Australian? I don't know. Now you confused me there, J.M. Hermosilla. Okay, La Churri, perfect, correcting it. A politician. So it's a politician, you guys think? All right, well, we're going to hear that in just a couple minutes, as you know, because we hear it at the top of each part of the show. Now, if you guys know who it is, okay, as I always say, you can tell us in the group on Instagram or on Twitter, but what's the problem? If you tell us, then you're giving it away to other people who maybe, you know, want to try and figure it out, okay? So if you want to tell me that you know who it is, you can tell me that without telling me the person's name. You know what I mean? In fact, it's a great exercise. You can practice like Leonardo da Vinci Code. You can practice being cryptic in English. And Jaster. Okay, let's see. Jaster says, I'm not going to leak who it is. Okay. So to leak, I think you say filtrar. No voy a filtrarlo. Oh, so Jester knows, but he's not going to. Jester, you know I love it, man. Don't spoil it for others. Don't give it away. No lo soples. Keep it to yourself. But if you want to show me that you know it, that you know who it is, well, you can give me a cryptic little wink, un guiño ahí, right? Una indirecta. All right, well, speaking of that little indirecta, that little hint, we've got to go to a commercial break. I can't believe it. We've already flown through the first part of today's program. We've got so much more to go. We're going to look at movies, music. We've got tons of games and so much more in the second part. Are you guys ready to rock? All right, cool. We're going to take a quick commercial break, but we'll be back in 2 minutes with tons more, my amigos. So, stick around.